understanding lignin is going to be crucial to go against climate change.
Lignin is the key component to a biobased society. It will be in our cars, in our textiles, in sunscreens that we apply on our skin. And achieving that, research will be essential. It will be a critical part of that journey.
Lignin is a component of plant biomass. It represents about 30% of the dry weight of all plants. However, we still don't know how it's made.
The interesting thing is that no one really knows what lignin looks like. So it's just a little bit like a black box. We cannot really say that this is the difference. We only see the outcome from our experiments, that they are different.
Lignin has been gained by plants to be able to enable them to grow up high on Earth, to be able to withstand disturbance such as wind, but also chewing by herbivores and other organisms. So it enabled plants 450 million years ago to rise from the ocean and conquer the entire planet. Without lignin, there is no land plants. So we know of lignin since a very long time, and we've been using lignified plant tissue since basically the dawn of human history. Although plants have developed lignin in many, many years, we are still unaware of how lignin is made, its diversity, because when we can better understand how a compound is made, we can then better use it. Here we've got the typical types of banana trees, and you can see that the stems here, which is going to become lignified, goes with each leaf joining up to each other to, in the end, make something which is analogous to wood. This is a grass initially. Lignin is what we call a polymer. So a polymer is the assembly end-to-end of smaller units. Good metaphor, good similarity of this would be a necklace, where every single unit is a different type of pearl. Each pearl have got slight variation in terms of what they can do, in terms of their speed, and in terms of their processability. So here what we have is directly a touch response of the plant towards my touch, as you can see it. I touch it and it tries to show that it's weak and it's wilted. And this is made by water movement throughout the cells on hinges and distinct parts which are controlled where the lignin is or is not. And that's enabling the water movement to shift and the cells to be able to fold and creating this very fast movement, as you can see when I'm touching it. So, plants have developed specific lignin polymers, specific lignin necklace, in specific cells to be able to fulfill specific functions. And this is what we're trying to be able to understand. So our approach towards to do this is called reverse engineering, and we do it genetically. So an example would be, let's say for the first time you get in contact with a cell phone. And you don't know how it works, and you've got hundreds of these same cell phones, and you're trying to be able to understand how do they work. You would open them up, take one component out, and see how it affected the function. So this is exactly what we're doing with the plant and its lignin. So our aim is not to be able to change plants, to regress them, but to understand how did they gain, using changes of environment, these specificities.
And then we have the if you get
the lignin is a large molecule and we want to break it up in smaller pieces. So the challenge that our team has at the moment is try to develop methodology for taking out the lignin from the biomass using green and sustainable methodologies, and also to transform it into something that adds value to the lignin. Most polymers are built up of a monomer that connects with one specific bond. Lignin is a polymer that connects with several different bonds, so it makes it more versatile and the chemistry is much more intriguing.
So we need to study of what is actually in here. As soon as we know the chemical composition of the bark, we know which technique to use to be able to get lignin from this specific type of the bark.
A few years back, we have developed a new technology that does not break up the lignin, but it puts a chemical group onto the lignin, so you can further build onto that. You can put on a function to make it work in different applications. You maybe want to have a strength, or you want to have something that can bend, you want to have something that is conductive, you want to have something that can harvest light or something like this.
This material may look like a plastic, but it's actually made of trees and the component lignin. It is flexible and it can be used in many different applications. So we want to use this renewable character of the lignin to make more our everyday materials in a way that is sustainable, doesn't generate new kind of waste or pollution, and that we use safe chemicals in the process of making those materials. So that is a great challenge, and we often deal with quite simple questions, such as how can we dissolve the lignin? How can we dissolve it in water? And how can we avoid using organic solvents, for example? I think the starting point for using lignin should always be that where we can gain most benefit from that, because it is a functional material of the nature, so we should also use that functionality and not just think that what it can substitute per se. And some examples are the companies who are developing sun lotions or sunscreens that are using lignin as a sun blocker, and that is utilizing the natural performance or property of the lignin. Then we are also interested of making these lignin-based materials that can be recycled. So we can melt them and stick them back together, and at the end of life we can then use it again or bring it back to the chemical components and synthesize the material all over again. We talk about circular materials that can circulate. That's the one of the motivations.
Since 1998, I've been going around the world, in France, in Japan, in the United Kingdom, in Sweden, all around, north to south, to always carry around this question on how is the cell using lignin? So yeah, I mean, I'd like to have the answer. I probably won't have the full answer before I die, but that's okay. I mean, I still would like to be able to make headway, and we already discovered quite a lot of factors explaining us how incredible this polymer is being made.